In Vermont, white pine is by far the most common species of pine that we have, but we do have another couple species, red pine and pitch pine, that you can also find in some parts of the state. Of these two, red pine is much more common. How we differentiate the pines from the other conifers is that the pines have these really long, thin needles. All the other conifers have needles that might be like an inch long at most, and white pine or red pine needles can be like 3 to 5 inches long. With white pine needles, we're usually on the shorter end of that scale, so we're talking about like 3 or 4 inches. Red pine needles can be much longer, like even 5 or 6 inches. As with all pine needles, red pine needles are in these little clusters called fascicles. And when I was in elementary school, I remember learning that white pine needles were in clusters of 5. And you can remember that because W-H-I-T-E, 5 letters in white, 5 needles. And I also learned that red pine needles were in clusters of 3. R-E-D, red. I don't know where that came from, but they are not in clusters of 3. Red pine needles are in clusters of 2. Without even looking at that, you can tell that these are red pine needles and not white pine needles because of how long they are. And also because if you take them and fold them in half, they cleanly break. They're much more brittle than white pine needles. If you took a white pine needle and you did that, it would just like fold up into a little ball. Red pine bark, to my eye, is mostly pinkish. It is super duper flaky. And when you zoom up on it, it almost looks like slate. If you watch the white pine video, you'll know that white pine has these upward arching branches that are covered in this sort of soft cloud-like foliage. But to my eye, red pine looks much more like a bottle brush or like a toilet brush with these tufts of coarse foliage. It usually won't have a big expansive canopy. It'll have like one big tuft of living branches at the top of the tree. Here's another example of a couple of those red pines. Looks just like a toilet brush. What most people know red pine from is as a plantation tree. These rows of red pine trees that were planted sometime between the 1930s and the 1960s. The reason that these plantations were planted in the first place was for soil stabilization from these overworked farm fields, as a future source of timber. And in the case of red pine, it was planted especially when white pine blister rust, this non-native fungal pathogen of white pine, started to take hold. Red pine doesn't get blister rust, and so people decided to plant red pine instead. And also, to a lesser extent, just to put people to work. So in the 1930s and the 1940s, the Civilian Conservation Corps, what we call the CCC, had an incredible number of people doing stuff like planting trees, building dams, building roads, all kinds of different stuff. So almost always if you see red pine, it's in a plantation. So there's just going to be rows and rows and rows of just only red pine. Although you will occasionally see it pop up on a south-facing slope or an area with thin soils. It likes dry soils. It is thought to be fire adapted, so growing on places that would have historically burned occasionally. Like red spruce here in Chittenden County, Vermont, red pine's never going to be a big part of our forest. But it is this interesting diversity element, and it's one that I actually really like to promote on the landscape because they're so uncommon that I know that they're providing really unique benefits to wildlife. The last thing I'll tell you about red pine that's like sort of my party trick when I'm out in the woods with landowners is if I see a red pine tree in the middle of the woods and it's just one, I'll point to it and I'll say, I'll bet you there's bear sign on that tree. And if you walk over to that red pine tree, you'll see that 9 times out of 10, it's a bear scent marking tree. So bears will actually stand up, they'll rub their back on the tree, they'll beat it up with their claws, they'll sink their teeth into it and bite it. So sometimes you'll see these areas of like exposed wood where they rake their lower jaw. It's one of the ways that bears mark their territory. And for me, just knowing that is enough to want to keep some red pines around.